Hi, I'm Jim Smyrniotopoulos, and we're going to be discussing intraconal lesions. If we look at this axial T1 weighted MR, fat suppressed after gadolinium enhancement, we can identify many of the normal structures. Superimposed, we have a drawing of the patient's orbit. We can see the globe and the lens of the eye, the medial and the lateral rectus muscles. In between the rectus muscles, we have the intraconal fat. And passing through the center of the intraconal fat will be the optic nerve and its meningeal sheath. If we look at this coronal image, we can see in better detail the extraocular muscles that form the muscle cone. We have the inferior rectus muscle, the medial rectus, the superior oblique, the superior rectus and levator palpebrae muscle. We can see the lateral rectus muscle, and we can also see the superior ophthalmic vein. Orbital masses are most commonly classified as being extraconal, conal, or intraconal. We're going to be talking today about intraconal masses and abnormal enhancement and lesions involving the optic nerve. The optic nerve has a blood-brain barrier, and the normal optic nerve does not enhance. Therefore, enhancement of the nerve is abnormal. If we have intraconal enhancement in the optic nerve and it is of normal size, this may be an inflammation or optic neuritis. If the optic nerve enhances and is enlarged, it may be a glioma, most commonly an astrocytoma. If we have intraconal enhancement around the outside of a non-enhancing optic nerve, this is most likely going to be a meningioma arising from arachnoid cell rests of the optic nerve sheath. If we look again at this axial T1 weighted MR, fat suppressed with gadolinium enhancement, and we imagine what we're seeing from reference to the diagram, we can see in the patient's normal right orbit, inside the green rectangle, that the normal optic nerve does not enhance. However, in the patient's left orbit, we can see abnormal enhancement of the optic nerve, but the nerve itself is not enlarged. This is most consistent with an optic neuritis. If we look at the coronal images from the same patient, we can see inside the green circle the normal optic nerve without contrast enhancement, and on the patient's left orbit inside the red circle, we can see abnormal enhancement of the optic nerve, which is nonetheless not enlarged. So abnormal enhancement of the optic nerve without enlargement is most consistent with an optic neuritis. Optic neuritis may be caused by multiple sclerosis. It can be seen as part of neuromyelitis optica or DeVic's disease. It may be caused by an infection such as Lyme disease or borreliosis. Optic nerve enhancement occurs in sarcoidosis with orbital pseudotumor and can be part of lymphoma. Optic neuritis is most common in adult patients, typically in women, because of the predominance of multiple sclerosis. The patient typically has unilateral vision loss that progresses over hours to days and may be accompanied by painful eye movements. The CT and the MR will show a normal to slightly enlarged optic nerve with contrast enhancement. These patients are commonly treated with steroids, and there may be spontaneous improvement over a couple of weeks. If we have intraconal enhancement in a mass lesion, the differential diagnosis changes. We can see here that there is an enhancing mass in the center of the muscle cone. If we look at the diagram, we see an enlarged optic nerve. This is most consistent with an optic nerve glioma, typically an astrocytoma. We must look very, very carefully for intracranial extension of this neoplasm. And in this case, we can see that there is involvement of the optic nerve adjacent to the optic chiasm. So here we have a patient who has an optic nerve glioma. This is a different patient with the same disease process. We can see the normal optic nerve diameter in the patient's right orbit. And in the patient's left orbit, we see an intraconal mass. The MR scan in this patient in the coronal plane without fat suppression shows us a normal diameter optic nerve on one side and the optic nerve mass on the other. After giving contrast enhancement and using a fat-suppressed T1 weighted technique, we can see the enhancing intraconal mass lesion, and again, the normal diameter optic nerve on the opposite side does not show contrast enhancement. This is most consistent with an optic nerve glioma. A third example of optic nerve glioma here, showing us in the red rectangle an abnormally enlarged optic nerve with abnormal enhancement on the right side, and the coronal image demonstrates the intraconal enhancing mass lesion. The normal optic nerve in the green circle does not show contrast enhancement. Optic nerve glioma. Optic nerve gliomas occur primarily in childhood because of their strong association with von Recklinghausen's disease, or NF1. These patients may have very slowly progressive decreased visual acuity. Sometimes the patient may not even notice the loss of vision. There is typically a fusiform enlargement and enhancement of the optic nerve. The optic nerve may also have abnormal hyperintensity or be bright on the T2 weighted image. Optic nerve gliomas in children, especially in NF1 patients, tend to grow very slowly. In comparing the imaging appearance of optic nerve glioma versus meningioma, we want to recognize that the optic nerve glioma enlarges the optic nerve in the center of the muscle cone. In contrast to that appearance in a patient with an optic nerve sheath meningioma, the tumor, the meningioma, is wrapped around the outside of the optic nerve, and very commonly a non-enhancing optic nerve may be identified in the center of the enhancing mass lesion. Let's take an example here. On the non-contrast image in the coronal plane on the left of the slide, we see an intraconal mass. If we look at the enhanced image on the right side of the screen, if we look carefully in the center of the enhancing lesion, we can see a non-enhancing rounded structure, which is the normal optic nerve. In the patient's left orbit, we can see a non-enhancing optic nerve in the green circle. So this enhancing intraconal mass surrounds a normal-sized optic nerve that does not show contrast enhancement. In this case with beautiful radiologic pathologic correlation, the axial T1 weighted image fat suppressed with gadolinium demonstrates a large intraconal mass. Passing through the center of the mass is a non-enhancing optic nerve. Let's take a look. Here is the mass lesion there. We can see schematically illustrated the normal optic nerve passing through the mass. If we look at this image in the gross picture after orbital exoneration, we see the same features. We see a normal diameter optic nerve passing through the center of a mass that was a pathologically proven optic nerve sheath meningioma. So this appearance of a tumor surrounding the optic nerve is strongly suggestive of a meningioma. Let's take another case of optic nerve sheath meningioma. In this example, the green rectangle demonstrates the normal lack of enhancement of the optic nerve in the patient's right orbit. However, in the left orbit inside the red rectangle, we see peripheral, somewhat nodular enhancement around the outside of the non-enhancing optic nerve in the center. In the coronal image in the same patient, we can see a lack of enhancement in the normal optic nerve in the green circle, and in the red circle, a ring of enhancement surrounding a non-enhancing optic nerve. So the enhancement is outside of the optic nerve in a meningioma. Terms used to describe this appearance include a target sign or a bullseye sign for the coronal pattern and a tram track or railroad track sign for the axial images in optic nerve sheath meningioma. In comparing optic neuritis versus meningioma, the enhancement is outside the nerve in meningioma. In optic neuritis, the enhancement is inside of the optic nerve. Optic nerve meningiomas, like all meningiomas, are more common in women, typically middle-aged patients. They arise from arachnoidal rests in the meninges covering the optic nerve. These patients may also have a gradual loss of visual acuity over months, and they may have mild proptosis. Calcification seen on CT is strongly suggestive of meningioma and is uncommon in optic nerve gliomas. The prognosis for these patients, like for most meningiomas, is very, very good, with an 87% 5-year survival. So in summary, when we look at intraconal lesions within the orbit, if the optic nerve is enhancing and it is not enlarged, it is an itis, optic neuritis. If the optic nerve is enhancing and is enlarged, it is an oma, optic nerve glioma. And if we see enhancement around the outside of the optic nerve, we must consider that the patient has an optic nerve sheath meningioma. I'm Jim Smyrniotopoulos, and I have approved this message. Thank you very much for your attention.